Today I'll be talking about the CBG station as a part of the CNG distribution. The CBG models were proposed by IGL, and the first model proposed is where MDP network is available in the near vicinity. CBG will be compressed at 5 bars by biogas plant operator and will be inserted in MDP pipeline of IGL. The pipeline will be laid by IGL at the premise of biogas plant. CBG produced will be purified as per IS 2016 and compressed up to 5 bars. Addition of odorant as per 15319 IS and injected in MDP and distribution to commercial and industries. Model number 1 proposed by IGL, the input raw material are cow dung waste management from areas in Delhi to be addressed, area of Nagli Dairy, Goyla Dairy and Balswa Dairy. Municipal solid waste management shall be addressed from area serving as mandi. CBG produced and inducted in MDP shall cater to demand of industrial and commercial area of Delhi, reducing dependency on oil and gas as fuel source. Oil and diesel consumption from upstream shall be reduced by 10% daily. Once these plants run on full capacity for MDP network of IGL distributed about 11,000 km across Delhi. Model number 2 proposed by IGL, only steel network is available. CBG will be compressed at 25 to 30 bars by biogas plant operator and will be inserted in steel pipeline of IGL. The pipeline will be laid by IGL at the premise of biogas plant. CBG produced will be purified as per IS 16087-2016 and compression up to 25 bar. Addition of odorant as per IS 15319 injected in steel network with serves large industrial customer along with online and mother CNG station. Model number 3 proposed by IGL, no MDP and steel network available. CBG will be compressed at 16 to 19 bars by biogas plant operator. The CBG will be compressed at 250 bar by IGL and filled in LCVs of IGL, which will be further routed either to IGL CNG station or domestic, industrial and commercial customers. Business model number 4, CBG. Producer, seller, party, entrepreneur shall deliver CBG at IGL existing or new retail outlet standalone selling point through cascades. Equipment for dispensing CBG at IGL existing or new retail outlet standalone selling point shall be installed and maintained by IGL. The CBG nozzle shall be manned and operated by IGL or its authorized service agent dealer representative. The outlet flange of the cascade inlet flange of compressor at the retail outlet shall be the point of sale for CBG. The cascade to remain connected to the compressor at retail outlet till the dispensing is operationally feasible. ACNG and LCNG stations. Introduction to ACNG. ACNG is formed by blending different proportion of hydrogen to natural gas. Two types of fuels are formed by blending the various proportion of hydrogen to natural gas. One is HANG and another is HiTHEN, which is formed when 20% of hydrogen is added to 80% of CNG by volume. Typically, the proportion of hydrogen by volume for blending the natural gas varies from 8 to 30% and HCNG mixtures with 20 to 30% hydrogen by volume are optimal for vehicle performance and emission reduction. There are 6 components which are required at combined CNG and HCNG station, which are as follows: electrolyzer, source of natural gas, source of hydrogen, CNG hydrogen blender, CNG storage tank, CNG and HCNG dispenser. Now electricity comes to the electrolyzer. then it goes to a furnace, and then storage of 400 bar of H2. This goes to the CNG H2 blender. The natural gas, on the other hand, goes to the CNG storage at 200 bar. It can be dispensed to the CNG carts and vehicles. Other part will go to the CNG H2 blender. And here H2 and CNG with blend, it will go to the dispenser, and that goes into the LCV and HCV as CNG H2 blended, or H2 is filled into the vehicle. This is how the HCNG station works. Introduction to LCNG. A LCNG fueling station compresses liquefied natural gas up to 300 bar in order to fuel CNG vehicles. An LCNG station is a CNG station except that gas comes from an LNG tank and is compressed at more than 200 bar at a liquid phase. Then the pressurized liquid is vaporized and heated to become gas. The gas is odorized if it is required due to national requirement and regulation, and is stored in high pressure vessels before being delivered. Another way to obtain CNG from LNG tank is that LNG is directly vaporized, heated from the tank, then goes through an odorizer, and the gas is finally compressed by a standard gas compressor. This solution can be advantageous if the operator does not want to maintain a liquid cryogenic compressor, but it consumes more electrical energy for the same capacity. This technology allows a single natural gas station to refuel both CNG and LNG vehicles. The concept is referred to as liquefied compressed natural gas LCNG refueling station. A CNG station is compressor based, and an LCNG station requires a cryogenic LNG pump and LNG storage tank. LNG and CNG combination station components. The first component is the CNG LNG combined pump skid, specialized positive displacement pump that compresses LNG to CNG. High pressure vaporizer elevates temperature of cold CNG to cell temperature range for dispensing into vehicle tanks. Third is CNG buffer storage vessels, required volume of 40,000 SCF at 5,500 PSI. Then the odorizer system odorizes the newly compressed natural gas for ease of detection. Fast fuel CNG dispenser with flow rate up to 120 G per minute. Safe fuel technology, clean energy advanced potential leak detection system. These are some of the components of the LNG and the CNG combination stations. We go to the recent CNG models. The first model is the company owned and company operated. These are all franchisee model, company owned and company operated. In case the outlet is developed under company owned category, the land will be taken by CGD entity on outright purchase or on long-term lease for a minimum period of 15 years with renewal option of another 15 years. The control of the CNG stations in terms of operation and forecast management shall be rest on CGD entity. It will also contribute intensively in branding of CGD entity and enhance the visibility and identity of the company. Though it is costlier slightly because all major investment, including the cost of land to set up CNG station, is borne by the CGD entity. However, it is preferred option because the control of the operation stage stays with CGD entity. The next one is the company-owned dealer-operated. The model is called the CODO. In case the outlet is to be developed under this category, the land will be taken from the selected candidate on lease for a period of 15 years with renewal option of another 5 years, and a trade margin would be payable to dealer by CGD entity on per kg basis. The last model is the DODO, which is the dealer-owned dealer-operated model. In this model, the dealership for operation is given to the landowners, offering the land for setting up the CNG station at the selected location. The entire yard mark plot shall be developed exclusively for setting up of CNG station and allied commercial activities such as convenience store, coffee shop and CNG service station at the discretion of CGC company. Once the sites are selected, the applicant will have to enter into a long-term agreement with CGD company. With this, we come to the CNG station and CNG distribution models. We have talked about various types of stations like the mother station, online station, and daughter booster station. We have also talked about the fueling methods like the time fill and the fast fill. And then we went into CBG. We talked about various types of model proposed by IGL for CBG. We talked about the LCNG and ACNG, and we have discussed that how CNG and H2 can be combined and how this combination helps in fueling the vehicles. In the last part, we have talked about the components of the LNG and the CNG combined station. We have talked about various type of franchises model which are in existence today in the CGD industry. Thank you very much.